收看的是华视教育文化频道，接下来要播出的是英文一。
Everyone, welcome to Watch English One, Unit 16. I'm 郭小晴，你是小郭。大家好，欢迎收看英文一的第十六讲的课程。The guest speaker for this unit is Dr. Barry Reynolds. Dr. Reynolds has helped us with a few units before, so Dr. Reynolds, welcome back.
Hello, everyone. It's really nice to see you all again. I'm glad to be here.
Technology has undoubtedly changed every aspect of our lives. It made our lives easier and it improved many things in our lives. Technology plays a large role in medicine. Barry, do you know any examples of technology applying to medicine?
Okay, well, I know about smart technology. Okay, the first devices were like jewelry, and they were designed to monitor patients' basic health indicators like blood pressure,heart rate, temperature, and breathing rate. But newer devices are being developed so that doctors can remotely monitor patients with serious diseases or even pregnant mothers.
刚刚雷博士呢有提到最新的科技呢应用在医疗上面，医疗呢，医疗的科技已经变成我们随身可以佩戴的饰品，那可以随时帮我们量血压啊，那测量一些身体的状况，那还可以提醒病人或者是甚至怀孕的妇女啊，帮助医生们了解他们的状况。So it's very technology has become very useful.
Yes, made things very mobile and much easier. Yeah.
Now we're going to go over the main text. Barry, would you please read the first paragraph for us?
Oh, sure. I would love to do that.
Thank you.
The rapid expansion of mobile health technology applications has made medical care more affordable to the public. For example, an ophthalmic refractometer, most often used for hospital eye examinations, costs over $10,000 and normally weighs more than 40 pounds. Taking advantage of high-resolution cameras, high-definition screen displays, and fast-growing computing powers of modern smartphones, researchers have been able to devise a novel mobile eye examiner that achieves similar results but costs less than $30.
This paragraph has talked about new medical devices that can bring down the medical cost. Now let's take a look at the sentences and their meanings. 我们来看这一段的句子。The rapid expansion of mobile health technology applications has made medical care more affordable to the public. 是指呢，行动医疗呢迅速的扩展，在广泛的呢使用在许多医疗的应用程式上面，那让大众呢更有能力能够负担医疗的保健。Rapid 是形容词，很快速的意思。Rapid expansion 是快速的发展。Application 是名词，运用。那这个字的简称呢，就是我们常讲的，现在手机也常用到的，就是 APP。接下来下一句 ，For example, an ophthalmic refractometer, most often used for hospital eye examinations, costs over $10,000 and normally weighs more than 40 pounds. 举例来说呢，眼科的验光机在医院使用来测试眼睛，这个一般的价格呢是超过$10,000，而且非常的重，重达有40多磅。For example 是举例，那我们也可以用 for instance 来表示。 An ophthalmic refractometer or refractometer 是医学的专有名词。Use for 是使用来做什么用途 ？Eye examination 是眼睛的检查。那我们如果要说耳朵的检查呢，就是 ear examination。那如果要讲是喉咙的检查呢，就是 throat examination。Cost 是花多少钱的意思。那英文的数字呢，我们讲1000块钱是 1,000， 那10,000块钱呢，就是10个1,000的这样的说法，就是 10,000。那讲重量呢，我们可以说 weigh 这个字，那它后面这个字呢加一个 t， 就是名词，就是指重量的意思 ，weight。好。我们接下来看下一句 ，Taking advantage of higher resolution cameras, high definition screen displays, and fast-growing computing powers of modern smartphones， 高解析度的相机、高画质的荧幕，还有现在的智慧型手机的高速的运算，这些功能呢，使得这些都是现代科技的一些优点。Advantage of 是利用，借由什么优点的意思。High resolution camera 是高解析度的相机 ，High definition screen display 是高画质的高画素的荧幕。Display 是名词，也可以当动词，是显示、陈列的意思。那像我们常逛街 ，we go shopping and we see window display， 就是橱窗的展示。那definition 呢，本来是定义的意思，但是在科技的产品当中 ，high definition 呢，指的就是高画质的意思。Researchers have been able to devise a novel mobile eye examiner that achieves similar results but costs less than $30. 那研究人员呢，设计出新的这种行动式，或是眼睛的测试器呢，有类似的功能。那刚刚讲，一般传统呢是需要10,000块美金，可是呢，这个应用新科技的关系呢，现在价格不到30块钱美金就可以了。Be able to 是能够的意思。那 devise a novel eye examiner 是指设计一个新的可以测试眼睛、检查眼睛的仪器。Novel 一般同学可能想到是小说的意思，可是呢，它在这边是当形容词，指的是新的、很新颖的。好，我们接下来看，examine 这个字呢是动词，那它的名词呢是 examination， 检查。那考试也是用这个字 examination，exam。那后面呢 examine 这个动词呢检查。检查后面加一个 r， 因为它字尾已经有一结尾的关系，后面加一个 r 呢，就是变成，做检查，的人或是检查的仪器。Achieve 是动词，达成、成就的意思。Achieve similar results 是达到类似的结果。Achieve success 就是获得成功的意思。Achieve goals 就是达到目标。那 less than 是较少于 ，less than $30 就是低于30块美金。那1美金如果等于30块台币，那30块美金其实就900多块，可以做眼睛的测试，那真的是蛮划算的。Now let's take a look at the second paragraph, Barry, please.
Okay. The pervasiveness of mobile health technology can be observed in innumerable medical measurement instruments.Such as the electronic stethoscope that can be used to track vital signs such as heart rate measurement, blood oxygen, blood glucose levels, and quality of sleep. Mobile health technology apps allow for remote access and analysis of medical images. In 2013, more than 40,000 health and wellness apps were available on the market.With the number of consumers approaching an estimated 500 million by 2015 and a revenue projection of billions of dollars by 2016. Although apps can provide mobile solutions to many medical situations through a user-friendly interface and readily accessible information, these apps can have serious consequences on users' healthIf these apps do not function as intended,
this paragraph has a talk about the medical technologies and many functions that they have. Let's take a look at the sentences and their explanations. 我们来看这些句子跟它的解释。The pervasiveness of mobile health technology 指的是行动医疗的一个普及。Pervasiveness 是名词，普遍的意思。那它的形容词呢是 pervasive。Can be observed in innumerable medical measurement instruments. Can be observed. 那can be observed 就是可以观察到的。那在这边呢，翻译会是说可以被看到、可见的。Innumerable medical measurement instruments 指的是呢，可以数、可以计算的这些可以测量的仪器、工具。Measure 呢？是动词测量的意思 ，measurement 是它的名词 ，instrument 指的是工具。好，刚刚我们是分开来看这几个单字片语。那前面呢的前半的子句呢 ，the pervasiveness of mobile health technology can be observed in innumerable medical measurement instruments， 指的是无数的这些或是相当多的医疗应用程式呢，可以看出来。行动医疗科技的一个普遍性。那它后面接的就是它的例子 ，such as， 例如说怎么样 ？such as electronic stethoscope， 电子的听诊器。electronic product 指的是电子产品，那electronic 就是电子的意思。such as the electronic stethoscope that can be used to track vital signs such as heart rate measurement。Blood oxygen, blood glucose levels, and quality of sleep. 像电子听诊器呢，现在不只是可以测量一些生，就可以测量很多生命的数据了。例如说，可以测量心跳、血液的含氧量、血糖指数的测量，以及睡眠的品质。下一句 ，mobile health technology apps allow for remote access and analysis of medical images. 行动医疗呢，在远端就可以，显现出医疗的图像跟做一些数据的分析 ，allow for 是准许的意思。那在这个句子呢，是使用于，可以准许，就是可以使用的意思。Remote 是形容词，指的是遥远的。Access 是使用的机会。Analysis 是名词，分析。它的动词呢是 analyze。In 2013, more than 40,000 health and wellness apps were available on the market. 在2013年呢，已经上市在使用的健康产保健的应用相关程式呢，已经超过有40,000多个了。Available on the market 是市场上有提供，也就是市场上呢已经有贩售了。With the number of consumers approaching an estimated 500 million.By 2015, and a revenue projection of billions of dollars by 2016. 预计在2015年呢，使用医疗保健软体程式的人呢，会达到5亿人之多。那在2016年呢，这一方面的营收呢，也会估计达到几十亿。那刚刚有讲到 1,000 是1,000，那10,000呢，我们要说10,000，那1,000,000是1,000,000。10 million 指的就是1,000,000。那如果我们要讲1亿怎么说呢？就是100 million。那如果说 billion， 那就是10亿。好，我们来看下一句。Although apps can provide mobile solutions to many medical situations through a user-friendly interface and readily accessible information， 虽然这大部分医疗健康的应用程式呢，它变得更方便，那它有很让消费者方便使用的界面，可以做远端的监控啊、管理啊，或者是追踪分析，那也可以提供医疗的讯息。Mobile solution 行动远距的一个，就是提供一个远距的一个方式，或者是它的一个方案。User friendly 是方便使用的意思 ，readily 是副词，很容易、快速的。那 readily accessible information 指的是可以快速方便取得的讯息。These apps can have serious consequences on users' health if these apps do not function as intended. 但是呢，同时在这些医疗的应用如果没有像预期般的运作，可能对使用者的健康呢也会造成严重的后果。Now let's take a look at the third paragraph. Mary, please.
Sure.To address such concerns, the United States Department of Health and Human Services Food and Drug Administration, FDA, issued a guidance document on September 25th, 2013 to inform manufacturers, distributors, and the public about the mobile health applications or mobile apps will be regulated by the FDA. According to the guidelines, regulatory oversight will ensure that mobile apps meet the definition of a medical device or an accessory to be regulated medical device, or something that transforms a mobile platform into a regulated medical device. As of September 2013, the FDA has already granted market clearance to about 100 such mobile medical apps. One example is a mobile app that uses a sensor connected to a smartphone to measure and display the electrical signal produced by the heart, called an electrocardiograph, or ECG.
Because of the widely use of technology in medicine, there are regulations needed. 就是越来越多有医疗保健的这些产品呢，那就有需要一些规范来管控它。那我们现在来看这一段的句子。To address such concerns, the United States Department of Health and Human Services, Food and Drug Administration's FDA.为了应付这些状况呢，美国食品药物管理局，简称为 FDA， 就是食品药物管理局。那台湾也有台湾的 FDA， issued a guidance document on September 25th, 2013。所以食品药物管理局 FDA 呢，在2013年的9月25号就发行了一份，公布了一份指南规范 ，to inform manufacturers.Distributors and public about how mobile health applications or mobile apps will be regulated by FDA. 那食品药物管理局呢，就告知制造商、批发商，甚至社会大众呢 ，FDA 将会开始管理呢这些有关于行动医疗或是远距医疗的应用程式。Inform 是动词，告知，让别人了解、知道的意思。According to the guidelines 指的是根据食品药物管理局的指南或是规范。Regulatory oversight will ensure that mobile apps meet the definition of a medical device or an accessory to a regulated medical device or something that transforms a mobile platform into a regulated medical device. 食品药物管理局呢，它最主要呢是要监督管控，它的重点呢是要看商品呢是否符合医疗器材的要件，或者是呢是否可以协助医疗器材的这些医疗应用程式周边的产品，或者是呢可以将医疗平台呢转成可以管理的这些医疗应用程式或者是设备。那这三类的这个应用程式呢，都会列为美国 FDA 所控管的范围之内。As for September 2013, the FDA has already granted market clearance to about 100 such mobile medical apps. 到了2013年9月为止呢 ，FDA 呢已经批准了有100多个手机的医疗应用程式批准它上市。Grant 是动词，准许、同意的意思。那我们如果说要同意发给学生奖学金 ，grant scholarship 就是颁予、授予学生奖学金。那如果说是 grant funding， 就是准许批准经费。下一句我们来看 ，One example is a mobile app that uses a sensor connected to a smartphone to measure and display.The electrical signal produced by the heart, called an electrocardiograph or ECG. 那举例来说呢，有一个应用程式呢，它是使用感应器连接着智慧型手机或者是平板电脑啊，来测量呈现心脏的一个所发出的电子讯息。那这个呢，也就被称为心电图仪或者是 ECG 是它的简称。Sensor 呢是感应， 感应器的意思。Connect 呢是动词，连接，那它的名词是 connection。Connect to 呢就是连接到什么地方。那 display 呢在这一句是动词显示的意思。那electronic signal 指的就是电子的讯号。We have invited a medical doctor to our program. Let's welcome Dr. Li. 欢迎李医师。
吴老师好。Hi, everybody.
Dr. Li, could you please tell us where you practice medicine?
Yes, I practice medicine in National Taiwan University Hospital.
李医师是来自台大医院。How long have you practiced medicine?
I've been practicing medicine for 14 years.
已经执业有14年之久哦。那 during the 4 years of your practice, have you seen anything special?
Yes, we do see a lot of application of medical technology in the hospital. And these medical technologies help patients and doctors to have better diagnosis as well as treatment.
那李医师讲啊，在这一段时间当中呢，一直有看到新的科技出现，然后也帮助医师呢，可以做一些更好的一个更精确的一个诊疗。那What other ways has technology helped doctors in Medicare?
Yeah, I can think of one example. In patients with heart disease.Previously, doctor can only diagnose with history taking and also physical examinations or stethoscope. But now we have more and more technologies. For example, we can have electrocardiograph or ECG. It can measure the electric activities of the heart. If the heart has a disease or a problem,We can diagnose the heart disease through the change of the ECG without open up patient's chest and or invasive surgery.
Wow, 刚刚李医师有讲到，就说利用科技呢，可以做进一步的诊疗。那过去呢，医生可能只能譬如说靠着听诊器，那或者是由外观来看。那如果有严重的问题呢，可能就要开刀手术才能看到心脏的一些问题。但是呢，随着科技的发展，那刚刚我们在课文里面有提到呢 ，electrocardiograph ECG 这个心电图的这个诊疗器呢，就可以协助医生去掌控心脏的一些电子活动。
And furthermore, now we have a smaller version of ECG, just like a bandage.So it can measure the electrocardiograph continuously for 24 hours or even for 1 week. It is compared to traditional ECG, can only measure maybe just 30 seconds of ECG. Now this new medical device can measure the heart problem for 1 week.
哇哦，医生刚刚有提到呢，传统的 ECG 它可能弄在身上呢，可能只能测量也许大约30秒而已。可是最新的发展呢，就是 ECG 可以就像那个我们贴 OK 棒一样贴在胸口上，就可以测量一天甚至高达一星期心脏的一些活动，所以帮助真的很大哦。
Yeah, especially for patients have arrhythmia problem, abnormal heartbeats. Sometimes the abnormal heartbeats will occur at some time, and only a short period of time in the 1 day. So this kind of continuous monitoring really helps doctors a lot.
哇哦，就是运用科技的关系，可以做一个长期的追踪。那因为有时候，刚刚医生提到，有时候心脏可能不正常的运作，可能只是短短一下子的时间，如果没有做长期的观察，根本是医生没有办法察觉到，病人可能也不知道，那直到发病可能就来不及了。那another question, mobile health has been so popular now and has been widely used.What benefits can mobile health bring to Medicare?
Now everybody almost have one or even two smartphones, and those smartphones have very strong computational power, and it is connected to the internet almost any time. So mobile health use the strong computational power of smartphones can provide a lot of capabilities to help doctors to monitor the patient's wellness or disease status. And the patient can benefit too. Patients, they can have more ready access to the medical technologies through the smartphone.
刚刚医师提到，就是这种远距医疗，然后因为现在手机非常的发达，那手机呢，电脑的功能非常强大，所以可以借由手机电脑的一个运算，然后把身体健康的资料传送到手机，可以立刻呢做一些追踪，那协助医师做一些健康情况的判断。Well, we thank you very much for coming and sharing important medical information with us.
Yeah, my pleasure. Thank you.
Now we will go over vocabulary and grammar. The first word, Barry, please.
Sure. Ophthalmic.
是形容词，眼睛的或眼科的。
Refractometer.
是折射计或是测量计。
Weigh.
动词称重量
，weight，
它的名词呢也是多加一个 t。
Women are more self-conscious about their weight。
女性呢对体重呢较为注意。
It is important to maintain a healthy weight to avoid diseases。
维持健康的体重呢可以预防疾病。
Pound，
名词是重量单位磅。
American Airlines have a luggage weight limit close to 50 pounds for economy passengers.
美国航线呢限制经济舱的旅客行李重量呢大约为50磅的重量左右。
Device.
动词设计发明。
The software company has devised a way for students to access software and school resources through cloud computing.
软体公司呢，设计一个让学生可以利用云端科技来使用软体以及和学校的资源的一个方法。
Pervasive，
形容词，普遍的。
Pervasiveness，
名词。
Compact cell phones used to be pervasive, but now more and more people are carrying big screen smartphones.
小型的手机呢，以前很普遍，可是现在越来越多人呢使用大萤幕的智慧型手机了。So they can watch videos on their cell phones.
Yeah, yeah.
And their eyes will
turn play
bad,
games, right? You know.
Now we have a lot of numbers in this unit. Let's tell our viewers how to write numbers.
Okay, sure. Let's go over that part, the grammar part about number writing.
好，我们现在看文法部分的字卡。
Spell out numbers at the beginning of a sentence.
那首先呢，就是如果数字出现在句首，就要把它每就是这个字给拼出来。
12 people had to leave their homes because of the flood.
因为洪水的关系呢，有12个人被迫要离开他们的家园。
Spell out numbers under 10.
如果是10以下的数字，就必须要把字拼出来。
This film has 5 sequels so far.
这部电影呢有五部的，到目前为止有五部的续集。
Use a hyphen with numbers from 21 to 99.
数字呢21到99之间呢，两个数字当中就要以横线来连接。
The virus killed 54 people.
病毒造成54个人的死亡。
Use commas with figures of 4 or more digits.
如果说数字有超过四位数字呢，那就要用逗点来把它们区分出来。
An estimated 1,600 people die from working too hard every day.
估计每日约有1,600人因为过劳而死亡。
Spell out the time when it is followed by o'clock. Use numerals when using a.m. or p.m.
如果是讲几点钟的话呢，那这个几点钟或者是 AM PM 之前，最好把字给拼出来。
Her grandma wakes up at 5 o'clock every morning.
她的祖母呢，每天早晨五点钟起床。I hope our viewers find the medical information useful.
Well, I found it useful. I think it's very interesting, especially the things that Dr. Lee shared with us today.
That's right. I agree. Right. Thank you very much for watching.
Goodbye.